What if I told you that women in an unlikely area of suburban Brisbane were making a huge difference to the lives of some of the most vulnerable girls and women in the world? All by sewing one essential product.
So what's your favourite thing to be working on?
Well, I'm a big animal lover, so I've been doing a lot of the RSPCA things, dog balls and dog beds and things like that. I feel like I'm helping doing something actually productive.
Every single thing we do for work is for a charity and community service, so it certainly makes you feel like you're giving back a lot more. Mm. Yeah.
The women speaking here are prisoners from Helena Jones Centre, a prison that focuses on confidence building and developing life skills by encouraging prisoners to work 8-hour days on community service projects, counselling and other programs.
So each liner gets a button and a clip and smack down. And you just put the button on.
Yay!
Look at you, contributing.
I do feel like I accomplished something.
Yeah. You just helped out.
Yeah.
What we're making here are sustainable pads that last up to 3 to 5 years. They're designed by the NGO Days for Girls, who work with the prison to sew and distribute free menstrual kits to girls and women who don't have access to hygiene products. Their aim? To provide education while diminishing period poverty.
I can see you've got what looks like thousands of pads and liners here.
We usually deliver about 200 to 300 kits.
That's every month?
Or? Yeah, that's what we've been doing lately, yeah.
Each kit comes with 2 washable pads, 8 liners, soap, underwear, a care and use sheet and more. Everything is designed to look bright and colourful, camouflaging it from looking like a pad so that girls and women don't feel embarrassed with them in public.
What is this?
It costs us $9 to produce a kit.
Gillian runs the local chapter. Globally, they've reached over 1 million girls in need.
Where do the materials for the bags and liners come from?
We don't get any funding, any government funding.
What do you think it means to these girls and women around the world who are receiving this?
Well, it's just giving them dignity, and hopefully it means something to them that we care what they're going through. Sending a bit of love, yeah, it's just lovely.
More than 12 million female refugees in the world have little to no sanitary protection. I first heard of Days for Girls while filming a documentary in a refugee settlement north of Lebanon, where most refugee girls and women are unable to find work. The lack of income and social stigma around periods means most of them are left with no other option than to use unhygienic materials that can lead to infections. To them, these pads are life-changing.
كنا ما نعرف هدول الأشياء صرنا نعرفهم أنا بستحق إنه أحكي إنه على الدورة الشهرية لأنه بستحق كتير لما بحكي بستحق لأنه في منهم ما بيعرفوا هدول الأشياء لازم يتعلموهم لأنه بكرة بتجيهم هاي الدورة وبكونوا ما بيعرفوا هدول الأشياء لازم يعرفوا
I have 2 daughters and when I think that they might have to go through the things that these girls do it's horrible.
So how long has Days for Girls been working with the prison?
5 years.
How many of these packs have you managed to put together?
51,000 pieces of sewing. So that's just phenomenal.
How does it feel knowing that girls and women all around the world who desperately need these kits are receiving them, hugely because of you and your team?
It's made a really big difference to how I feel about myself.
Can I ask how it's changed how you feel about yourself? In what ways?
It makes me feel like I'm making a real contribution back for what has happened in my life. Yeah. So that's really important to me. Yeah.
I think one of the biggest things is that they can relate to women and girls that they know are being helped by their actual work that they're being done. Mm-hmm. And I think that gives them a really great sense of satisfaction that they can be a really important part of somebody else's life. I love seeing these women developing new skills. It doesn't matter what their circumstances are here, they're still making a huge impact.
it's helping people that need our help. And to be needed is a good thing, you know? Yeah. To help people is a good thing. We get the chance to help people. It's not wasted time or dead time. We're using our time for something good, something productive. Right? A lot of high security jails and that, you do nothing all day. Here I have the chance to wake up, do some good, go to sleep, and it's another day down.
Hey there, my name is Mark Fennell, and if you enjoyed that, and I'm hoping that you did, then make sure you like and subscribe to the Feed's YouTube channel, and definitely watch that thing that I have absolutely seen before. It's really good.